Okay, here it goes again. I'm actually not anymore sure if I really record through my microphone here or if it goes through the microphone of my monitor or even of my laptop. I just had the sensation when my headset was unplugged and it was still recording, so my voice, which is very interesting. So, okay, I'll come back to the point here. You know, guys, I had a run on Mozilla Firefox, and it's only getting worse. It's not getting better. And this guy here, Brian Lunduke, he made a very nice video. Our links is in my YouTube channel under this video. It's really worthwhile watching, guys. I just rant, you know. I just say exactly what I think. I mean, I call a shuffle a shuffle. If somebody spies on you, he has lost your trust. He should have lost your trust. You should not trust anyone who cheated, lied, and deceived you with injecting code into your browser without your knowledge. Like in case of the German Firefox users, which were used as guinea pigs for their click and count company, or all the other things they do. Guys, they are, as I can only say with Brian Lunduke's words, Mozilla has proven to be not trustworthy. Just because they have nice words in their mission statement and they talk nice, but they have to be very careful. What do they say and what do they do? If everything they say is the opposite of what they do, screw what they say. Honestly, guys, have a little bit self-respect. Do not let people spy on you. Don't let them betray your trust. It is your privacy and you got the power. So if Mozilla, all this, what they have is their Firefox, yeah? If you don't use it anymore, what do you think is going to change? I mean, Brian Lunduke, he speaks in his on the end of his video, like that Mozilla would have to fire these managers which are responsible. What the heck? Do you ever think that would happen? Have you ever seen that justice actually got the criminals, the real, massive, big criminals, brought to justice? No, that's not going to happen. But here's another thing. You got the power. If you, and I mean, if I reach just one person, that person tells it's a Chinese chessboard, you know what I mean? On the first you put one, on the second you put two, on the third you put four, on the whatever, on and on and on. It always doubles, right? So it's a huge amount coming together. So if you stop using Mozilla because of what they have done, because I do not believe that these guys who are sitting on the top, they have the biggest elbows, they are ruthless, reckless, in my opinion, and that's how they got there. And they have the ruthless, reckless methods and actions shown with spying on you, injecting code to your browser, using German Firefox users without their consent and knowledge as guinea pigs, with their click and count thing. Guys, they don't go away. They will not change. That's not going to happen. That's gone. So if you donate money to this company, I would start thinking twice. I would give that money a different browser building company. Somebody who hasn't got this money spying betrayal ambitions. I would give it a company which is doing what they're saying, you know, trying to be honest and really support a free internet and stuff like that. I mean, this is so outrageous. This is so outrageous. I mean, you try this as a private person. You try anything they have just pulled off in the last months. Just a single thing like that. You pull that off. You hear all about it. You're not going away for free. So do not trust these people anymore. Do not trust any company or product which spies on you. They didn't it not only once, they did it twice in a very short period of time. That means they give a swear-free channel here, you know, They'd give nothing about you or your opinion or your privacy, because they just keep doing what they do for all the good money. So please do not trust them. Do not support them. Do not use their browser anymore. So for me, in short, I'm using WaterFox in a moment, which is a Firefox, not really a fork, but it's taking the spyware out. So if the Mozilla employees can hear me, especially the developers of Firefox, make a fork, split off, get the heck out of a company like this. This is a sinking ship, and it will sink fast. If more people make people aware that Mozilla is spying on them, abusing their trust, and I mean, if I would say that's the thing here, if I say what is really on my mind, they would say, oh, this is a criminal offense. Pardon me, what? I'm telling you the truth, and that's a criminal offense, and you lie, deceive, and betray trust, and that is totally okay. I mean, yeah, I know that justice is blindfolded, but what the heck, guys? There should be coming an end to all of this. I try to stay out of politics, because I'm not really interested in politics at all. Not so Mozilla. Mozilla is very interested in politics, and they're very interested in keeping the net not an open internet. They want to regulate everything. But I don't want to repeat what Brian Lunduk said here. I put that video link in my YouTube description, and please have a look at it. Just listen to what this guy says. He's collecting the facts. He's doing it a little more diplomatic than I do. I'm just the outraged user of a browser from a company which is reckless, ruthless, abusing my trust, doesn't care at all about my privacy, and does what they want, whenever they want, and whenever they like. Under the false statements of we want the internet to be open and free, and we care about your privacy, and it shouldn't be optional, blah, 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 blah. So, guys, listen to what people say or write a statement, but check what they do. And do not judge them by their words. Judge them by their deeds. You know? I mean, it's in the Bible, right? It's better the guy who says, no, I don't want to, and helps you, than the guy, of course, I come and help you, and he never shows up. So, you know, this is the same thing. If they say, oh, yeah, how do they say, like to say this nowadays, we are really interested in your privacy. Yeah, they're interested in your privacy. They want to know what you're doing. We have nothing to hide and we're not doing anything special, we're actually not trustworthy, but it is a principle, people, and it's not a big or small principle. Principles are neither small or big, they're principles. And it seems to be that Mozilla has demonstrated happily, luckily here, that their principle is we do not care about anybody's privacy, we care about our money, and we do everything necessary to get the money, doesn't matter what. So if you ever donated to this company and have a monthly donation, I would actually stop that. I would not support a company which spies on me, breaks my privacy rules and trust, and injects code in my browsers without telling me, or even would use me as a guinea pig just because they're doing some business model or whatsoever, or selling some new click technique counting stuff. Guys, wakey wakey, you cannot let this happen. Do not let this happen. I mean, I'm not your mom and dad, so, but I might have to talk with them if you keep using Mozilla Firefox or any of their products. So, in short, I have to see what browser I will use in the future. I might have to go away from WaterFox too. I have to have a deeper look in WaterFox, because I trust the guy has a very good intention, because you see, he figured that out. He knew already that Mozilla is doing what they want. So I haven't had this injected code in my WaterFox. But on the other hand, from what point on will he be able to identify what they use to inject code and what were not? And will Mozilla close the gap? Trust me, what they have shown, you can predict that they will try to close that gap, because they want to have their business, they want the money. So, and they will find a way to, you know, I mean, Windows 10, they made it legal. They just said, okay, sign here that I have all the rights on your computer. You don't even own the software. We can take data as much as we want.
And trust us, we're doing only the real thing. We do it only to do help you making your experience better. What the heck? I mean, Plex started something equal to this. You know, they don't let you opt out anymore of some options, privacy options. And that's a huge concern. And I don't know if Plex is aware of this, neither is Mozilla. We are millions of people using Linux. If we say no and make people aware of it and say do not use products which spy on you, these companies can just go and get their food stamps. Because this is it, that's the end for them. There's no more. And if other businesses are smart, then they will see and say, okay, that was one of these managers, he ruined Mozilla or he ruined Plex. It's better not to employ a guy like that because I like my business running. But the world is not smart, proven. But as I said, we can change it. I'm not Mr. Robot, don't you worry, I will not inject code. I think I'll leave that to Mozilla and other, in my opinion, crooked companies which do things like that without the consent of other people. In my opinion, it's a criminal act. This is a criminal or a criminal offense. Yeah, I mean, just think about it. Just think that idea a little bit further. It is a criminal offense, in my opinion. It's an invading of my privacy from a company for business. So where's the difference between a guy with a gun on a superstore and tries to get some money because he likes it so much, like Mozilla likes their money? Or where's the difference? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, this red meat was life. Maybe they're just forcing. Maybe they never had the intent to pull the trigger. Maybe they're just using it as a threat. I mean, I wouldn't try to figure out the difference. That's just a word of advice. I might have been carried away here a little. So what I say is my opinion. But if you see my, as you can see, my opinion is based off tons of facts of things which happen. I call them deeds. They're done. It has been done. They left a trace. They're discovered. They're visible. They're known. And that should be enough. I can actually not understand that. Sorry, Serge or Sergey, I have to say that. If somebody spied on you, you're still using their product? Really? Yeah, we all did that with Microsoft for a while, but that's why I joined the Linux community in 1990-something. To keep them going, you know, to stay on the ball and find something which works better to get off all the monopolies. And we're finally there, we made it. Linux is, in my opinion, superior to anything that's on the market. That's why all the supercomputers running Linux. Okay, FreeBSD, you're on the same way and you will get that too, but I have only a certain limit of lifetime. In the moment I'm not living in my unperishable body and can wait forever, so I use Linux because it's already there and it is where I wanted it to be. And independent of my wishes, it made its way and that is great. So back again, guys. I cannot stress that enough. I mean, honestly, just ask yourself, would you finance somebody who is spying on you, who betrays your trust, who does things hidden from you, but on your computer? This is your computer. This is your computer. You bought it, and it is your internet connection which has been used, which you pay for. Well, what's the heck? So if somebody takes a joyride with my car, is that okay nowadays? Well, I didn't make a scratch. I just drove around and did some tear and wear on your car and some fuel, but who cares, right? I'm walking away, so leave me alone. I just needed to do that, right? Is that okay? I mean, I'm just a dumb guy and I may be old-fashioned or whatsoever. Maybe I've watched too many John Wayne movies or something. I have no idea. Something must be wrong with me or with the world. So guys, wake up. Do not support companies or products which spy on you. If you donate it to other companies, those who do what they say or not even have said things but do protect your privacy and work for you. Yeah, which, I mean, tons of Linux people are doing their stuff, they're developing stuff, like, I mean, everybody here, XFCE, I mean, I call XFCE all the time. I mean, even Ubuntu, they're making money, but they haven't dared to do anything like that. If somebody says, oh, but they put Amazon on. Yes, they did, but it was visible, and they made a mistake, they corrected it. And that's the difference here, you know. Repent, you know, that's what our God says. Repent, and it's all good. Everybody can make a mistake. But in case of Mozilla, that does not look like a mistake. It's done on purpose. It's done repeatedly. And if you watch the video from Brian Lundick, there are worse things what they do in the background. I personally would not want any business at all with Mozilla. If I need an army of lawyers to check if they don't want to trick me, what the heck would I be doing? So I can't understand other companies who don't want to do business with them. You know, I mean, yeah, some people call hitmans and need them for something, but, you know, not a crooked one, because he might just come for the guy who paid him. As shown in the case of Mozilla, right, and Yahoo and things like that. But guys, I mean, I want to keep that video short, but it's impossible to make it short. It's too important, and I'm repeating myself here, and I know, and I have no idea anymore how to stress that enough. Guys, do not finance with your support or money companies or products who spy on you. And you don't need to have repeatedly spied on you. If somebody spies at you at the first time, that is called broken trust. You gave the trust for free because you believed what they said that they would do and keep in these boundaries. Obviously they haven't done it, and if they do it a second time, then you just get confirmed that taking my trust away, not using the products, was the right decision to do before I get more harmed on the way. So, I don't know how to say that any more better. So I would say, guys, yes, if people think I make long videos, they're not true. Watch Brian Lundyuk's shows. I guess he has some videos in, some advertisement in it. I just don't do it. I'm not interested in any money. I don't know if YouTube puts any advertisement on my videos. They shouldn't, because I don't want to have it monetized. I just want to show them. And yeah, Vidme is going down because they stood on their own toes. You could never create a channel because there were too many limitations. So what did they think is going to happen if you want to run and you stand on your own toes? I mean, I should work as a consultant, you know. I would become so rich, and the companies I'm involved with, they would become very successful. But yeah, it's the same, like, you know, when Walmart was so smart in our town area to say, oh, we don't take Visa card anymore. Oh, you will, 100% you will. You will just make a few million minus and pay somebody who was so smart telling you this, and then you go back on your knees and take Visa again. And of course they did. And there are so many examples in my life where I could tell people, right, in that common sense is not always common knowledge, I think. I have no idea. Yeah. Yeah, don't get me started. Don't get me started. Otherwise, the rant goes over the whole world. This is it. I will switch it off now, guys. If you have an idea, what is a good browser? I mean, I used LastPass. I started EndPass too. And I have to have a look. I want to use either LastPass or EndPass. And I would strongly recommend for LastPass to support other browsers now too. I still have my Chromium. That works. I've got my Tor browser. But in a moment I put an add-on on, I might just get something which is calling home. So I could be tracked. I mean, I'm not doing anything criminal stuff, so I don't care. Really. But I care that I don't sit in a glass house, and I care most about people who think they could put a bug or a camera or anything to observe me in my own house, in secret, behind my back, without my consent. That's when I get allergy, right? That's when my neck hair goes up. And that's where it stops. I mean, if I think back, they would do that in my grandfather's times, they would be hanging on a tree. They would, no question asked. They would be sitting on a horse with their nice necklace, and then give the horse a clap, and things are done. It's sorted. But nowadays, we're all so tolerant, and, you know, and forgive, and you know what, call a shuffle a shuffle. You don't have to kill people, that's for sure, but you don't have to support them either. Do not support companies or products which are mistreating your trust and your privacy. Do not support them with money or with using their products. They do not have your best interest at heart. They have their own interest at heart and they go over your dead body if necessary to get the money. I don't know. I mean, what's going on then with these people? They do everything for money. What the heck? I, it's just money. Man. Okay, yeah. So, yeah, as you go, what browser is a good browser? I know there's something like a Qt browser. No, you're not. I will not Google for it. I will wait for you guys to come with something useful and tell me about it so that I can actually see what is a good browser. And I hope that if I can get this thumbnail, otherwise I might have to just have a screenshot like this. I'll save a picture of it goes. Because I would really like to that this has been seen on the video. And this is not my work. I just, you know, guys, I jumped on it right away. Brian Lundyuk, he took more time, so he gathered more facts. And he expresses himself very nicely, but also firm. But it seems that he thinks on the end that Mozilla would fire these managers responsible. I mean, that's not going to happen. That is not going to happen. This won't happen. They do it again. They will try to hide their tracks more carefully, but it will not stop because they will not fire the people responsible for it. They most likely fire the whistleblower who made that possible, that people started recognizing stuff, because, you know, that's what everybody forgets. You know, they all think, oh, we have an army, we sent the army. Oh, pardon me, the army is folk too, and it has been shown more than once that the army starts taking action to protect actually the citizen from corrupt governments, right? I mean, it was in Hitler times, the Night of the Generals, and stuff like that, and there are many, many, many other examples where that happened. So people, wherever they are, and wherever they are, and what position they ever they are, they should be aware. You're just a handful of people. There are millions and billions of people out there. They're not getting them all, and they wake up, and when they wake up, there is no stopping anymore. So, but we don't have to get radical here. We just have to take radical measures and stop supporting products or companies who spy on us. And if you think Firefox is such a loss, what is the loss of your privacy worth to you? Or your dignity? You know, are you anything worse? Obviously they think. So then you think of yourself that you are something worse. So protect your privacy. Have some dignity. Say no. Use something else. I mean, it's you just insert Chromium, say you have to close Firefox then, whatever, if you really use it, do not. And then import bookmarks and you get them all, this is it. And you get all the extensions which you get on Firefox, you get on Chromium. And for downloading YouTube videos, you don't need this. I have a video out how you can use YouTube-DL on a CL command, and if you really need to see it, I can show you how to put it on Ubuntu with a GUI. So then just drop in a comment, Dirk, you said something like I can download videos with a GUI. Oh, where is this? Show me. So now I'm going to do that. So, guys, do not, really, please do not support companies or products which spy on you, which mistreat your trust and yeah, everything from you. You know, you put your trust in them, you believe their mission statement. Watch what they say and see what they do. You know? And if it is so obvious, if it comes out, this is not by accident. Somebody risked something to make that visible to us. You know, somebody in this company was sitting, or a group of people, and said, look, as to all going pear-shaped here, we have to warn the people, we have to make it visible so that even a blind with a stick can see. And it happened twice, so now we know. So we cannot ignore this anymore. Man, I did not want to go political, and this is not supposed to be political. This is just against any crook. You know, everybody who tries to cheat, lie, deceive you, does things in your background, behind your back, and for his own advantage. So I call these people crooks. Because in my opinion, in my world, that's where what they are, and that's what they do. They do crooked things. They are dishonest, and yeah, if they give a mission statement and they do the opposite, then they are liars and deceivers. because the mission statement is like a honey brush, you know, you get honey brushed and then, oh yeah, it sounds so good, let's give them some money. Stop giving people who break your trust, invade your privacy, and do things on your computer, your machine, and you're into using your internet for their own purpose. So do not give them any money. No. Especially if they're using the money to make the internet not free anymore, to block certain kind of people for what reason soever to use it. I mean, just go in greater detail, watch the Lundock show, this one here. I will put that link in my YouTube video. And it might sound like a hoity to prominent saying this because people are just not listening or they do not understand. So I try different ways, different scenarios to break through. I don't know if people get brainwashed by TV, radio show, and you know, ha ha ha, it's all, no, we really meant well, it just got misunderstood. No, it's not a misunderstanding. You did something behind my back, you used my equipment to spy on me, you broke my trust, you did not do what you said you're going to do, your whole mission statement is a lie. It sounds great if you would deal with it, I would fully support you, but all you do is lying, deceiving, and you broke my trust, and you used my computer for your purpose, and you injected code in my browser, which I use for my personal stuff, you abused it, and you used people as guinea pigs without their consent. So, this is crooked, this is not right, this is, do not support people like that. Just listen to what I just said. That's all happening to you too, you just might not know it, right? So, what the heck, do not support them. So I'll push the button here, now I get out. I have to get to my dartboard where I've got a Firefox symbol hanging and I have to throw a few hundred darts on it. Yeah, I think that's what I got to do. Okay, guys, if you're still not convinced from what I say, do yourself a huge favor and watch the Lundock show from Brian Lundock. The Mozilla is not trustworthy. You will find it in my description for my YouTube video. You will be even more upset, I hope. I hope you understand what he's saying, what's going on, that is a real thing. I just don't share his... I think he has a positive outlook that actually would happen. They will not fire the managers who are responsible. They might just shed some blood, but that is not the people who did all this, because they want to keep doing the things, you know. For me, if they would ever want my trust back, I don't think that's going to happen in this lifetime. That is so rampaged, abused, broken, that, yeah, only if the Linux community would monitor everything, all their products so closely like they use to monitor Linux, then I would say, yeah, okay, guys, I would try it, because then I have an army of billions of people protecting me from their spying tries, stuff like that. It's disgusting. It's bleh. Yeah, I have no words. I hope that expressed a little bit what I think of what these creatures have done. It's really disgusting. It's beyond words, and there are no words to express the disgust they produce. It's amazing. It's, yeah, in a very bad way. It's amazing that they go away. That's what I don't understand. How can they go away with that? But there are many examples in this world where I can say, you know, people just do the most despicable things, and then they go away with that. Until they're not, you know. But this time is coming, I think, because more and more people getting awake and say, what the heck is going on here? What did they just do? Yeah. Okay, so this is it. I want to go in politics. Guys, browser ideas. We have to be creative now. We have to search for browsers. And if they're not that good in the beginning, doesn't really matter. You know, Firefox wasn't good in the beginning. We helped them, made them to become what they are. We even gave them money. But now, oh, hey, this sounds like Wargaming and World of Tanks. Yeah, it's exactly the same thing. They listen first, and then the users, players, with their ideas and experience, build a really good game. And then these same kind of creatures, different bodies, but the same kind of mindset, sneaked into their company, and now it's disgusting what is going on. It's money begging. The game is rubbish. It has been so bad. They lost, I think, in the last month, what I could see, at least another 10,000 players. And they throw all the premium stuff in for people to buy this from a dying game. And the thing is, it wasn't necessary. See, that's the thing. If Wargaming would be smart, it was not necessary. It was a good game. It would have kept going, like with Mozilla Firefox. It was a good browser. It could have going on and on and on. And but, you know, you break people's trust and just look after your own business. You become selfish, reckless, ruthless, and telling the untruth, because you can't call these liars anymore liars. No, they're just people who tell the untruth. Yeah, that's lying, actually. Just different playing of words. But they want to disarm what you say, so you can't say it anymore, because that is a crime. If somebody injects code on your browser and diverts or sends you advertisement you don't want to see and influence your browsing experience and everything, that is legal. What the heck is that legal? Pardon me, can somebody explain that to me? And I don't want to have a lawyer twisting every word you say. And, you know, that's just something like common sense, and that's what people in the earlier days had, and that's why they were so far more dangerous. Because when they had enough, they had enough. And we should have enough here, and we should not support these companies anymore under no circumstances. You cannot fall back. Trust me, if you use Chromium, do you think that, oh yeah, my internet is now so slow and I can't really watch what I want? No, you will be even better off with any browser, because you won't be restricted anymore like them. And this is just what came out. What else do they do in the background? You know, usually you see the top of the iceberg, but you don't see what is under the sea, right? And in my opinion, what I heard, an iceberg is bigger under the water than the top you see. So what we have seen here is the top of the iceberg. So be aware, do not use that anymore. Do not use any software or product or use anything from a company which is spying on you, right? Do not support them. 100% do not donate money to them under no circumstances. Did I turn in circles here? Okay, guys, I need browser ideas. In a moment I use WaterFox. I will have a closer look into it so that I can have hope. And I hope the Linux community starts looking into browser alternatives too, and that we get some good, safe and sound recommendations. I'd rather have a slower browser, and I have to skip some add-ons if these companies like LastPass, if they wouldn't support other browsers, then this is it, then it's goodbye LastPass, right? Then we use XPass or NPass. There are tons of companies which like our custom, and we can just go to them. There's no problem. What they want is your money, and and the good thing is, some try it on an honest way. They just earn their money and say, look, this is what I sell you, and that we respect actually your privacy, and they do. And then you buy their product and you recommend them. Yeah, that's what you do. And then if that is an open source or non-profit company, then you start supporting them. You know, 1 million people gives $1 a $1 million. So, and trust me, if what do they do, $500 million Mozilla in a year? Yeah, if you remove your support, I mean, this could break their neck just like that. If enough people wake up and say, you know what, I'm actually not breathing through Mozilla, I can use any other browser and it will do the trick. Yeah, it does. And no, you won't be stranded. Yes, you can watch your YouTube videos. And yeah, you can watch Netflix. And yes, you can do other stuff. And no, you're not getting blocked from anybody just because you dropped Firefox. No, you just did something to protect your privacy and hopefully protect the internet from people's private agenda to make it the way they want it. You know, and that is not free. That is against all the other people who like the internet. Yeah. Okay, I don't know. I think I've tried every angle I'm capable of. This is it. Who hasn't figured it out yet? My opinion, I don't know anymore how to help you, to protect you. If you haven't understood yet what is going on, just think of the top of an iceberg. That's just what we saw. Everything else you haven't even seen yet. and it might not come out, and I don't care if it comes out. The most important is I care is don't use their product anymore. This goes away from by itself. It just dies off.
If people, you know, that's another thing. You change the industry. If you stop using privacy-breaking spying products and don't support anymore these companies and products, the industry will change because they say, oh, you know what, we are not living long enough. If they figure out we are spying and we are tricking them and we are breaking the privacy and all stuff like that. And trust me, with the Linux community alive, oh yes, we have tons of people watching what programs do. And that's a really good thing, and I'm grateful for these nerds, what people call nerds, that they do what they do. So if somebody, a nerd, comes and fixes your computer, give him a coffee. Get him something from McDonald's, get him some ice cream, whatsoever. Because he's working for you, he did something for you. Yeah. So that's why, you know, it's always good to drop some money in the Linux community somewhere. Not much, you don't have to drop the hundreds of dollars. Drop a dollar here, $2 there, and you know, if a million people do this, that's the $1 or $2 million dropping everywhere. And that's good. That keeps the Linux community going. You have nerds, how you call them, looking into your network traffic, and they figure out if somebody's calling home, like word 4 and stuff like that. Or it's a long time ago, but that's when they got caught already. Yeah. And why did they still grow? Because people did not care about their privacy. They believed words when people said, oh, sorry. They're not sorry for what they did. They're sorry you caught them. And that's the difference. If somebody's really sorry, change his ways, yes, give him a second chance. What we have seen here, in my opinion, Mozilla wasn't really interested in a second chance. They just thought, you know what, we give it another shot. Maybe they're so dumb, they haven't really reacted at the first time. Now we give it a much bigger shot. And if they still stay with us, then we can do what we want because we have blind, dumb sheep following us, and we can melt the cow until it can't walk anymore. So do not be one of those guys. Don't be lemmings. You don't have to run down the hill. Under no circumstances. Turn around. Stop. And honestly, what do you think happens if you stop using Firefox? Oh no, end world scenario, nobody can breathe anymore. No. Use Chromium, or in a moment still Waterfox. And you won't see any difference. Might it be a millisecond slower? What the heck? Who cares if you can keep your privacy in return? Right? So, this is it now. I think that's 5 minutes gone. Take another 5 minutes and watch Brian Lunduk's video here about Mozilla is not trustworthy. Because it's true. This is dang right true. I cannot. I'm so grateful that there is another human being which recognizes fraud and crooked behavior and points it out and said, look, guys, this is actually fraud. It's crooked. It's invading your privacy. It's abusing your trust. It's abusing your computer, your internet. They use you as guinea pigs without your consent. What the heck? Man. So, this was it now, guys. I might give it another shot one day. I do not believe that Thunderbird is still under their thumb. They still call them Mozilla Thunderbird. I would really recommend to get the Mozilla out of it. It's the best thing you can do, you know. Do not have the name Mozilla anymore in your name Thunderbird. Just call it something else. I mean, iStove was nice, right? That's not wrong. Yeah. So, I personally have to do some research. I have to find a better browser, more safe, more sound. So that means we have to do some research in it, maybe even drop the message in some Linux forums and reviews so that people have a look, so that we get maybe a list of safe and sound browsers. If they're a little bit slower, who cares? Well, who the heck actually cares if it's a millisecond slower? They all have tab nowadays. Some do it better, some not so good. But the not so good is still better than raping your privacy. So, no, it's not okay. It's not okay. It's not okay. And you must not let this happen. Nothing happens if you drop Firefox. If you want all your bookmarks, export them. No worries, they might have a copy of it too. And get in Chromium or whatsoever, or in Waterfox, and just import the whole thing. Job done.
And for now, you can keep going, and then we figure out what browsers are options. And I think I have to make videos about browser options so that I can rub it into people's mind to not support companies or products who are spying on you. I mean, I said it a few times now, but it seems like I just can't break through. Yes, I had one nice comment. One guy on a WaterFox video said, "I just installed it." Well done, well done. So you have done the first step to protect your privacy a little bit more. Good job. I can only say very good job. For everybody who is uninstalling Firefox, absolutely good job. Do not forget to save your bookmarks or import them before you uninstall Firefox, but get rid of it. Get rid of it. So, yeah, they can inject code in your browser, on your computer, and they break through your firewall and everything because it has access, right? So, yeah, get rid of it. Get rid of it. Don't leave a thorn in your side. You don't have to have pain and hustle and misery and sorrow and what the heck. So, this is it now, guys. Please, if I couldn't convince you that's possible because I'm not the word acrobat and I don't do nicely studies. I know all the stuff, but I can't bring it nicely and like Brian does here. I mean, why reinvent the wheel? Why would I make another video as good as Brian Lundy's? I'm not going for clicks. I don't get any money out of here. I'm not interested in any money. My interest is really not monetary. My interest is people. You know, my God says, love the Lord, love the people. That's what I do. And I used the Linux community a lot. I learned a lot from these people. Now, sadly, some started dying. Now it's my time to carry the torch, and I will do that for a while as good as I can. Are my videos as good as theirs? No, because I just started. I have no idea. I'm just doing what I do. And I try to rattle people's brain and to make them aware and say, look, you're not safe. People abuse you. They think you're dumb. You're not dumb. They abused you. They worked behind your back. They didn't trick you because you were dumb. They did that very smart behind. And I have zero respect for criminal intelligence. I'm one of those guys who despise criminal intelligence. It shouldn't even be called criminal intelligence. It's just a sick mind doing something very perverted in this world. That's what it is. It's not intelligent. So my ears are beeping. There are two black men in front of my house. I think I have to go and see what they want. No, I'm not. But okay, guys, really, if I couldn't convince you, watch Brian Lundy's video. Mozilla is not trustworthy. Link is in my in the box where I write my stuff, whatever you call it. If I have convinced you, really get rid of your Firefox as fast as you can. Do not support Mozilla financially or with their products, anything like that. Get the heck out of there. Do not get involved. Watch Brian's video anyway. I mean, I don't usually advertise other people's stuff, but what is good is good. I call a shuffle a shuffle. He made that video very, very clearly, very nice, very good job, Brian. Good job. Thank you for doing that video, Brian. Taking your time. I mean, yes, he has monetary stuff going too, but that's more that gives him the time to do it how he does it. I do everything here spontaneous. I just jump on the microphone and said, got to warn the people, got to warn the people. Oh no, they get abused. We have to tell them, let them protect themselves before it's too late. So that's my thought, right? I don't have a script, I don't have a nice microphone, my webcam, one of the first webcams I think possible. My laptop has one, but it's off, except the NSA is switching it on just to sweep my room here a little bit. Firefox or Mozilla can't do it, and they're really annoyed about it because I uninstalled their stuff. Do the same, and please, if I haven't convinced you, watch Brian Lundy's video, Mozilla is not trustworthy. Sergey, hey, let's make it this way, Serge. If your name is pronounced Serge, it's number one. If it's Sergey, it's number two. So write in the comments, it's number one or two, then I know it's number one would be Serge, number two is Sergey. Because I don't know how to pronounce your name. And I've got no video coming back from you telling me, Dirk, you do this totally wrong all the time. No, man, don't you dare. So I've tried to pronounce your name properly, I just have no idea how. So I'm with a stick in the dark, or try to describe the color to a blind man, right? So, this was it, guys. Really, I have to. It's now, I think, 6 minutes and longer. Watch Brian Landuk's video here. It's worthwhile watching it. Trust me, it's worthwhile watching. It's not that 1,000 people watch that video for nothing. I might have 10. That's okay with me. I mean, if I reached one person, it's Dirk, job well done. Honestly, if just one person uninstalls Firefox, because I could rattle him awake. I got rattled awake, guys. I'm not here the ultimate whatever omen and know all this stuff. By no means. Absolutely not. We're in a community. Everybody helps everybody. So I'm trying to help others. Well, I got helped. So this is all it, you know. One hand grabs my left arm, I grab the other's left arm with my hand, and that's how we do it. Stick together, guys. Everybody for everybody. Yeah, I have to work on these words, right? Because like politicians, you know, they sound so nice, each and every one of you. You know, that sounds so nice, and in reality that they just vote me that I can do what I want. Yeah, each and every one of you. I must now they use this. It's so amazing, the words they're using. You know, a politician can talk for half an hour and say nothing. It's an art, I guess. So, okay, but I don't want to go in politics. I have zero interest, and this is purely just protect your privacy, your own dignity. Do not let anybody abuse you as a guinea pig without your consent and all this stuff. So, watch his video if you haven't watched mine. It's in the description box of my video. I know it's a little bit long, but as I said, I try to really get you guys awake. This is not a cavalier's delict. This is not something a gentleman happens, you know. This is not an accident, and this is nothing small, and it's not funny either. It's none of this. It's absolutely serious what happened here. And some people made that happen for us so that we know. So let's honor their deed, that we say, okay, we got the message, guys. Thank you so much for making this visible to our eyes, that we see what's happening here. So let's their sacrifice. Most likely they lose their job whatsoever. Not be for nothing. They meant well, they did well, and we have seen now what's going on, okay? Yeah. This is it now. It might be 7 minutes 30 seconds this video, but this is it. Have a good night, guys. I hope I reached out at least one person. One person, then this was worth 10 hours of my time. Okay, guys. Sorry that it took long, but I try different angles because I do this spontaneous. I just try to find common sense, common logics, compared to situation in your life that you actually see what's happening, because sometimes we get blinded, especially from nice words. But just watch what people say and what they do. If I tell you, oh no, this is not commercial, this channel, and will not monetize, and switch on YouTube advertisement and start getting clicks and money, and this is wrong. If I say it's not getting monetized and I would put up Patreon and would mention it, then it's not monetized because this is voluntary. If I switch on advertisement, then you would be forced to watch it or click it away until if you want to see the content of my videos. But as I said, it's not of my interest. I work for my money as everybody else. I try to give back to the community. Some things take longer. Monday I have a nice microphone and stuff like that, and until this is what you get. And I hope it helps, because it's more interesting what I say than the equipment I'm using, except if you use Linux. I mean, yeah, I'm biased. I like Calculate Linux. It's a really good thing. It's a very, very nice distro, very well made. And yeah, it is just, I want to make another video about it, because I throw everything I have off my Pavilion HP laptop 17-inch, everything out, because now I got my Synology stuff running. I've got Cloud Drive Station, I've got Cloud Backup, I've got my Synology Notes. And everything what else comes seems to be now running totally fine. I can just do it. That's all I wanted, because it seems that Calculate Linux is the only distribution running on my Pavilion without giving me any hassle. And that is what I want. I don't want any hassle. So no glitches, you know. Even here on my gaming laptop, Ubuntu, I use it for gaming.
But then I have all of a sudden, you know, these symbols, my icons vanish, and if you go over it, then they appear again. So there's a glitch. Is that glitch with the NVIDIA driver? Is the glitch with the Ubuntu environment? I have no idea. And I don't care. I care, I don't want it. And, yeah. It seems to be that I'm fussy, right? So I don't want to give away... I would like to enjoy while I can, and it's for free and it's good, that I can use here this operating system. It's great. But as I said, it might not be for everybody. Not because it's difficult. It's not difficult. I declared Calculate Linux actually girlfriend-friendly and wife-friendly. And if I say that, I'm 12 years married. This means something. Trust me. If you know my wife... You know that I risk it all here. When I say this is girlfriend friendly, I would put it on. For more than one reason. My wife is sometimes in areas where she doesn't have internet. And I updated Calculate Linux, and I think it stood still for at least 6 months or longer. And yes, it was a 800 megabyte update, but it runs through just like that, and it worked fine, and no hiccups. No key ring, key is wrong, blah, blah, blah. No, you know, all this stuff that you get from Arch. I haven't had that. It just worked fine. And as I said, I mean, I'm always looking here and I go, bang, look at this. This it might be literally, but I like it so much. Yeah. And if you say, yeah, but this is what Firefox is for me, it's not worth it. If this would spy on me, I would kick it out. I wouldn't care. It could take half a minute. I would rather take the half minute and I don't get lied and betrayed and abused than having something what, you know, Firefox, you know, other browsers can do that too. Give them the money you give to Mozilla Firefox and they overtake them. And they're honest. And that counts. That counts. Anything else doesn't really matter. Nice words are useless without deeds. But then again, you know, you will say, Dirk, you're a Christian, you permanently bombard us with stuff from the Bible. Kind of, because the moral and all this stuff comes from God, right? And he is the only one I know of who has nothing really selfish. You know, I was looking into this and I said, oh man, I said, okay, so what is it about God? I couldn't find a single thing where he said, that is mine, you can't have it. It's the opposite. He said, you know, everything's mine. I would love to give it to you, but you know, show some responsibility. Because every time what he calls sin is either hurting myself or others. There's not a single thing where he said, you can't have it because I don't want you to have it. Everything what he calls sin is either hurting me or others. Am I without sin? No. But I'm aware. And I try to do my best. But that's it. That's all you can do, actually. We're human beings. We're in a polluted world, and you see with Mozilla how far pollution can go. You know, they killed Jiminy the Cricket. You know, no more conscious. I mean, that's how I see it. These people have no more conscious. Just imagine this, how far they go. And they sleep at nights. If I would do things along something like that, then I could not sleep at nights anymore. I would feel guilty for such a long time. I would never try to do it again. But there's a difference. You see, that's when you have a conscious, if you have a functioning human mind, or if you're just ill and sick. You know, in my opinion, this is sick. This is sick. They did not need that to do that in order to keep their business running. It was not necessary. It was not life-threatening. They didn't save anybody with that. The opposite. They abused tons of people. And the trust of tons of people. And yeah, it seems I just added another minute on my 5 minute video. But this is it now. I don't know how many people listen to the end. Would be interesting to know. You just write, I watch to the end. So I know, because I think there will be non-comment on the end. It doesn't really matter. If somebody just writes down, Dirk, uninstall Firefox, then I'm happy, then job well done. Just one person is good enough. I'm happily spent my time here to debate your privacy and your protection, and that you shouldn't give in under no circumstances. And yeah, well, that's worth my time. If I can just save one, that's good. Good job. I don't know if I have done. I'm very sure that Brian Lundyuk did. If people think that, what, I have 112 people, the manager from Mozilla said, no, we don't like your video, it's bad.
Look at this. I cannot believe it. I mean, yeah, but this is the, is it the Helsinki syndrome? When people get, you know, when they get, from terrorists get kidnapped, that they all of a sudden on the side of the kidnapper? Helsinki syndrome, you know? I mean, maybe there are just 100 managers and 5 have a Helsinki syndrome. sadly, nobody will hear this to the end, I guess. Yeah. Okay, guys, I cut it off now here, but I hope that just one person, it's, I'm happy and glad if one person writes, okay, I uninstalled this crap, and I don't want to see it ever anymore. You know, this is it now, guys. Next video will be a little bit more functional again. No idea what I do, but I think it's really time to the VeraCrypt, TrueCrypt installation. I will do that on a VirtualBox. Sadly, my VirtualBox here doesn't work yet. Annoying! So, I might have to go in Ubuntu again. I mean, don't get me wrong. Ubuntu, they carried the torch for Linux a long way. They made lots of things happen. And so, do not underestimate the influence, the good influence Ubuntu had and still has. They're still doing a good job. So, yes, I make my fun about Ubuntu and stuff like that. But it is a reliable, user-friendly Linux distro. And it's pretty good. If you go for the LTS, do not go for all the other stuff, actually. Not if you're just a user. If you want to have them developing, finding beta testing stuff, sure, go for it. If you need a working environment, go for the LTS. And that was it now. Now I'm cutting off, you guys. This is it. I wish you a good night. Merry Christmas. Even though I might make another video before it happens all. Wish you all the best. Keep your privacy. Keep your dignity. Don't get abused, don't let this happen, you don't have to. And uninstalling Firefox is not the end of the world, it just continues nicely. Don't you worry. Okay guys, thank you for those who were watching. I know nobody will hear this ever, because it's too long. It doesn't matter if one person alone said, Dirk, uninstall, I'm totally happy, even if you haven't listened to the end. It's not about listening to what I say, it's more understanding what I say. Translate it into your life and make your decisions based on some facts. And what I said, yes, I call it my own opinion, but it's based on facts. And you can get the same facts. You just have to research if you want to, or just watch the video from Brian Lundig. He did some good research, and this is it, guys. Okay, I'm out. Have a good night, and see you later. Bye-bye.